hippopotamly? Isn't there something that we Indians can do? I mean, we Indian Maharajas. Isn't there something that we can do to get rid of you bloody British from Indian soil? What? Isn't there some bribe that we can offer you to go back to London, where they don't need you and you are the scum of the earth which they sent to, well, they sent all over the world? To sum up the matter, there's something we can do to get you out of India. You know, that's one of our primary desires. I hate to say that, but being friends, you know, we can be frank. Can I offer you a whiff of this hookah? Will that be enough to get you out of India? What? If I offer you a whiff, just one whiff of this hookah, tobacco is expensive, especially the type I use, will it be enough to get you out of India, to go back and settle in England where you can smoke a Sherlock Holmes pipe instead? What? Well, thank you. Thank you, Raja Maharaja Singh. Oh, this is a wonderful hookah. What do you call it, a hookah? Well, I'll take more than a whiff on it. You see, why just take a whiff on it? I'll take the entire hookah, right? By force. We British don't beg for things like whiffs of hookahs. We take the hookahs when we want them. Understand? So Maharaja, Raja Maharaja Singh, from today this hookah happens to be mine. And the next whiff will be mine. What a whiff. That whiff ought to be enough to get us out of India. I think after smoking this pipe of yours, I no longer have any intentions of staying on in a country where they smoke these contraptions. Okay? So I'll take it with me and give a whiff of it to Queen Victoria and see what she has to say about it. I think she smokes Indian hookahs. She took one the last time when she was here. Okay, so now, forgetting about the hookahs, about your saying that we British should get out of India. Well, it's about time we got out of India, you see. I've been having nothing but diarrhea ever since the time I came here, you see. The water is polluted. You see, you polluted the water with cow dung. I know that. And this isn't the age where water filters have been invented. See, Aqua Guard and all those things haven't come into existence as yet. So what I have to do now is to see that I can comfortably and in good health and well-being get out of this country before it is too late. But there's one thing I want to see before I go. And unless I see it, I will not leave India. Neither will I order the East India Company to get out. As a matter of fact, I'll order them to get in more and more. In, and then out. But that the getting ins will take a few hundred years more. Right? By that time, the tobacco in your hookah might be finished. So, Mr. Maharaja, there's one thing that I want to do before I quit India. You know, we people who came with the British East India Company were primarily businessmen. We never went to school, you see. We never even went to grade school. Our general knowledge is zero. We are dumb asses, and you are quite right, we are the scum of the earth. So when the scum of the earth demands something, it gets it, right? Now what I demand right now is to see a tiger. I've heard of those jolly good tiger hunts on which you Maharajas go, right? And I promise you that after you have shown me a tiger, taken me on a tiger hunt on that vast elephant of yours, which I don't happen to see around here, I will quit India. But I must go on a tiger hunt with you. What does a tiger look like, by the way? Does anyone have any idea? As I said, we never went to grade school, so we don't know what a tiger looks like. Does it look anything like a mouse? Bigger than a mouse? Maybe like a mongoose? Right? So when do we begin the tiger hunt? What? We are already on a tiger hunt? What do you mean we are already on a tiger hunt? Then where's your elephant? Why am I not riding on your elephant? What? The elephants got out of here when they couldn't stand the scum of the earth. Okay, that means me. Doesn't matter, we can go without elephants. I can ride on your back. Instead of making a machan on a tree to shoot the tiger, I can make a machan on your back, Maharaja Singh. How's that? Okay, let's get to work. Let's go to the jungles, right? Let's go to the jungles and get a good look at the tigers, and I will claim the first shot. Okay? So let's go! What's that horrible sound coming from the jungles? It's a teeny weeny little animal there. A teeny weeny. What? I've got the telescope on backwards. Well, that's the way it's meant to be, backwards, so that you can see small animals, because these small pistols can only shoot small animals. What? That's a tiger? Okay, it isn't very big. It doesn't look very big. So Maharaja Singh, come in front of me before the tiger gets me. Right? Bang! Hey! Lord Bottomley, you shot my turban off. Is this the way to shoot a tiger, you ass? My turban! Never mind. There's the tiger! It's in front of you! Maharaja, you shot my head off! That's revenge! Revenge isn't sweet, especially when we are confronted with a man-eating, hungry tiger! I'm getting out of here. Maharaja, you can keep your tigers, you can keep your tiger hunt. Call the first British flotilla for me to escort me back to India. I mean to England. I'm getting the hell out of India!